Best of one historic. Thopter Foundry? Retrofitter Foundry? I haven't played historic in ages, so. We shall see. Am I supposed to mulligan this hand because I don't have the foundry? I mean, probably, right? Like, am I gonna draw the foundry? Guess we'll see if I can draw it. I don't think drawing it is a trying to draw it is a winning line there. Lately, I have windows that just won't. They just they try to stay on top, regardless of what's going on. It's kind of odd. Is there a point to playing this now? There isn't, right? I should save it for when I have the two drop in play. Hypothetically. I mean, the opponent knows I have it now. Hey, it's the two drop. What is this? Green? What do they have? Mana Tithe? Nope. Doing the thing. The intrepid two drop sails forth. Uh-oh. Not doing the thing anymore. So I have to hold up the counterspell. The plural. I don't know why I'm so amused by Ornithopter. 4 mana. I can just counter it. So it's just gone. Or I can draw a card. I mean, next turn they might have 5 mana, that's the problem. Wonder if I'm supposed to block there. So can I even play the Smith here? I don't know what to name. What, Resplendent Angel? I need to have a list of historic decks. Maybe I don't play it for now. I just don't do anything. I need to draw a Thopter Foundry, right? Yeah, it is Resplendent Angel. So, oof, I should have played the tap land there. That's a misplay. Oh, the foundry. I need this. Sacrifice a Thopter. Create a 4/4 token. But I don't need to do that now. I don't need to play. I guess I could play Pithing Needle, but I might as well save it for next turn. That way they don't know that they're. Well, it costs 6 to activate Resplendent. What's it anyway? Uh-oh. Kind of a disaster. Two or less. So I guess I'm playing Pithing Needle here. I could play Portable Hole for nothing. I don't want to do that there. Portable Hole with no targets. I wonder if I'm supposed to attack with Mutavault there. Muta. So they're at 9? Why would they attack? What? Ah, that's why they would attack. I forgot that they were that the thing was gonna trigger like that. So I have to block. I can get a Thopter back, Loris. I might just be doomed, right? Six. Okay. So it's just a loss. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. I don't think I've misplayed. And again? I guess I could have saved the Thopter Foundry for a turn on which I could pay to untap it to get 2/4/4 flyers instead of one. And there was like land sequencing problems, but I guess I didn't make any major misplays that I'm aware of. I just lost to their wombo combo. What's going on? Wow. Nice. Wonder if I'm supposed to throw a land back here. Probably, right? Mutavault. Planes, rather. Need to draw removal, or I think I'm doomed. They probably have their own removal. Am I supposed to hold Ingenious Smith? No, I'm not, because I can get a Thopter from it. That is not a Thopter. Neat. How about three planes and a reprieve? Is this a Thopter? It is. Guess I can hold up Iganja to kill Balmore. There's a Thopter. Okay, so yeah, that's the line. Thopter or hold up Iganja. Well, that's the line I'm taking, I should say. I guess I'll just block Baltimore if this is what they're doing. So this lets me. When I destroy this, this doesn't go off, right? And yeah, so if I kill the Reckless Rage target, it fizzles. I guess I'll find out. No, that is not true. Neat. Because it's 4 damage to the critter and 4 damage to another critter. It has two targets. So removing one of the targets doesn't affect the second target. I guess I could have looked up the Reckless Rage question and not lost there. Killed the Soul Scar Mage. So, what is this? Draws cards. Counterspell. Not a counterspell. They wanted to pretend like it was a counterspell. Foundry makes the deck run. So, I can make a servo on their turn to turn this into a 3/3, or I can just make a Thopter right now. I guess this is also a Thopter right now. I can still make an artifact on their turn by sacrificing the Thopter. Never seen this card. Four, seven, eight, 10. I don't get there. Eleven. This costs too much to activate, right? Yeah. So it's just this. I guess I could have wait, but 12. There's not enough mana for 12. So I can either attack with Mutavault or hold up Mana Tithe. It's got to be hold up Mana Tithe. Why are they, what? Why do they have priority right now? They have, is Force of Will in, on Arena? Or the other wonky counterspell? Oh. What? They don't have any lands. Neat. It doesn't count non-basic lands. Deals damage equal to the number of non-land cards. I feel like that's just an oversight of not counting the dual face things. The cards that can be played as lands, as lands. So there's no point turning it into a Thopter. That just makes it worse. So second foundry lets me pay three to make a 4/4 between the two of them. That's probably what I should do. I guess playing Hope of Europoor gave me a sacrifice target this turn. I could animate, swing for seven. I think I'll just play the Thopter and use both foundries. Thopter. Four, six. That's only three there, so I can put this in my hand. Oh, wait. No. I'm misreading them. Not right at all. I should have made a, what's it there? That was a misplay. So they have protection from everything? I don't think there's a point to me playing Lurrus. There's no point in attacking. Neat. could have ended up with another 5-4 there. Counter spells don't do much. Three, five, seven, eight. So putting back in their hand is correct here. Surely I don't have a second Mana Tithe. They had the untapped land in their hand. Okay, so what can I do? There's a car alarm going off. I go to 18 and take 8, 10, 13, 14, 17. Awesome. I owe the one ring kills them, unless they remove it. Or I can't count. Nope. It's 17. Until your next turn, can't cast non-creature spells. So the one ring kills them. Because they try to save their life with the draw and gain life equal to cards in hand thing. Well, one out of three, looking pretty dismal. But that was control with a dream trawler in play. I mean, they could have just let me draw a card and kept a mana. Well, no, they had the untapped land. They played into the second mana tie. I probably would have lost if they resolved the White Sun's Twilight. Wonder if you're supposed to lead with a Esper Sentinel or Foundry. Second Smith. I guess Sentinel lets you draw cards. Smith lets me discover cards there. Not discover cards. Draw cards in a selective way. Draw a card. Oof. She played Sentinel. Pithing Needle, Changeling. I don't know what cards are in the mill deck to target with Pithing Needle. Portable Hole just gets rid of that. Maybe that's the line. I mean, are these decks targeting this Thopter deck, or is this just bad luck? Like, I have to portable hole here so I don't lose the game. And I have to hold a reprieve for the same reason. So, second, Tasha's Hideous Laughter just doesn't end it. That is sorcery? It is. Cool. So I was supposed to know to hold up reprieve in case they had Tasha's Hideous Laughter. That's playing to not lose, not playing to win. Maybe these are just best of one things. Should have played the cave first. Is there a point to having the Foundry in play? I don't think there is. Since if they do nothing, I can make a server. I'll just counter it. I guess there was a point. So I can play Mana Tithe. Second Mana Tithe. I mean, I guess I was supposed to play Shadow Spear there. I don't know, they shocked. So maybe they were gonna play another card. It's the deal four thing. No, it's deal four, deal two. Regardless. So I could sack it? No, I couldn't. Yeah, never mind. Wonder if I'm supposed to play Shadow Spear here. Second Balmor. I mean, do they have the second, Reckless Rage? They have something. So this whole process costs 6 total. Yikes. Five. I have to go for the win. Reckless Rage. It's not Reckless Rage. Wizard Lightning. And it seems like the deck needs many of the spheres. The 4/4s are kind of easily dealt with. Is this the same hand that I just had? It's pretty close. These six cards are the same. I don't know if the last hand. I think the last hand might have had a white dragon land instead. So maybe it's just these five cards that are the same. So, am I supposed to hold up Reprieve here to counter whatever they want to recur with Arcanist? I'm not going to, but maybe I am supposed to. I don't know. Reckless Rage. Now am I supposed to hold up the counter spell? I don't think so, still. Not when I can play this stuff. Well, no. Yeah. Reprieve doesn't even fix Reckless Rage. It just puts it back in their hand. They just replay it. Is Crocs a good target for Reprieve? I guess it goes back into their hand. Maybe it's not such a good target. A55. Trouble. So five other cards. So they want Arcanist in the graveyard. I guess it depends on if they have another land in their hand. I guess Crocs are resolving. It's just backbreaking there. So I have to pass. They do have another land. They are going for Croxa. Wait, are they? Now they're not? Oh. They're gonna discard the other card in their hand. So I have to play Thopter, sacrifice it. Oh, it doesn't have flying. I keep thinking that the 4/4 has flying. I guess it would be too good if it did, but that line was just completely incorrect. That was a misplay. This can't block the 5/5 flyer. So I chump with the Thopter, so that was just a misplay in more than one way, because I could have blocked with the Thopter and then turned it into a 4/4. That's pretty bad. So, what? I don't need white mana. I mean, I should have tapped a Mutavault there. So I have to have a Thopter so I don't lose the game. And then from here I can reprieve and make a survey. Yeah, these five fours are not very threatening. The opponent has nearly infinite blockers. It's not nearly infinite, but they have a steady supply of blockers. So they block. Okay. I attack out. They block these three, take four. Stitcher supplier gives them more critters in their graveyard. They don't even have to block three. They can block two and take eight. 4, 6, 8. What does Luris let me do? Play Ornithopter? I probably should have resolved Luris a while ago. I don't have a non-land card to discard. Oh no. Auto tap got me. Cool. I guess I lose then. Go to one. Yeah. Nice. Nice. I mean, that's my mistake, but nice. It's a fitting end. Auto tap does not have my best interests at heart. In fact, it really wanted. It's because Mutavault can turn into a creature that it doesn't want to tap it. I guess. I needed to just manually tap Mutavault anytime I was casting a spell on a turn in which there was no chance of me needing Mutavault. During a turn in which. Is this the mill deck again? So their next turn is Tasha's Hideous Laughter, which this deck is extremely weak against. That's not Thopter's Hideous Laughter. So I'm better off getting rid of founding the third path. Because it's 14 cards. Yeah. There's no way one card is worth not attacking, I don't think. There's Tasha City's Laughter. Neat. Yeah, so the deck I'm playing just cannot be played. Because it loses to this, which is being played. I mean, this is pretty low stakes at the moment, but like, I definitely can't play this in the qualifier, which means I should be testing something else, but. I'm not really into historic. I'm not gonna craft another historic deck. I'd rather just hoard my wild cards. Like, you'd have to have a great draw and hold up the counter spells on their turn three and just indefinitely to not lose to Tasha's Hideous Laughter with this pile. Is it the same deck? What's going on? I miss some sort of, I mean, if their next play is the third path, then, so be it if it is. I have to play to win. It's probably supposed to play automaton instead. Tasha's Hideous Laughter. Let's see it. They're on ninjas. Mana Tithe is probably most impactful on turn three against their deck. Like, what four drop do they play? They didn't activate Kaito. Two cost removal spells. No. Two Thopters. Why not? So I can Pithing Needle Kaito. Becomes a 3-2 Death Touch. Eight or more cards. I'm at three right now. Should have done this post combo. Instead of giving them information, it's in this way. I mean, good portable hole target. There we are. Richard Fitter Foundry helps conceal Mana Tithe, conceal priority, conceal that Mana Tithe is playable. Say. It's one of my pet peeves about Arena, that it leaks so much information. I mean, I guess I could play with full control all the time. draw some Thopters. Maybe I can draw the 2-drop. Ingenious Smith. Or who's it? What's it? I've forgotten the names of all these cards. Portable Hole. Oh no. I think it's a loss. Activated abilities, unless they're mana abilities. Neat. Nissa. Hand's pretty bad. I can probably just go next. A little late. So I have to pithing needle that thing. That's Elvish War Master. Six, they all become 5/5s. It's actually Allosaurus Shepherd, not War Master, but I need to get the needle. I mean, I'm still pretty doomed. I'm not going to recover from this pitching. Like, what do I do here? I just lose. I would have to have some sort of board clear. I'm not going to play in the qualifier tomorrow. Is there a feather deck? Not since 2022. Yikes. Yeah. Maybe just a heroic deck in general. There's the Smith. There's the portable hole target. I need the boundary. I can hold up counterspell and Iganjo here. Are they gonna block with Dragon's Rage Channeler? Almost certainly not. Oof, I forgot to play Ornithopter. That's a misplay. Yikes. And now it's in shock range. I should have just played it after combat and accepted the error instead of compounding it by waiting until the next turn. There's the Foundry. I mean, if you have an instant, it's not an instant. Why didn't they do that pre-combat? Foundry. I guess I don't need the white mana. I was supposed to play out the Ornithopter because of Robber the Rich. Yikes. I guess this incentivizes them to attack. I mean, they were always attacking. Yeah. Oof. They got Pithing Needle. What a disaster. It's pretty funny. So... whoops. So I can attack for 2, 4, 8, 12. I feel like some people just get in the habit of attacking. Foundry? It's not Foundry. Oh, was that supposed to portable hole the enchantment? I probably was. Whoops. Here's the foundry, but I have to portable hold the enchantment. I wonder if I'm supposed to ignore Kiora. I don't know. Probably. I say as I attack Kiora. I think they have some, what, Nissa? Some sort of 5-drop that they were really excited about playing. That's an excellent draw. So, Foundry. What sort of flash green spell do they have, or instant green spell do they have? 36. So, pithing needle prevents Kiora from giving them mana. I might as well just keep this 2-1. So here's the 5 mana card that they were so excited about. It's Cavalier of Thorns. Okay. I just attack out because I have to. They have a ridiculous amount of mana now. Maybe I can draw a counterspell. It's not a counterspell. Crater hoof? Yep. Storm the festival. So they're looking for a Kiora. It doesn't work. Pithing Needle catches all the Kioras. Pithing Needle is pretty critical here. Tasha Avatar Buddy. It's gonna enter tapped. I guess the earlier I have a 4-drop in play, the better off it is for me. Not a 4-drop, a 4-4. If I wait a turn, I can make this a 3-3, but I don't think waiting a turn is correct. Maybe I can. Whoops, I should have done this post combat. It's a misplay. Another Thopter, and I can hold out reprieve. No, I can't. If I draw a land, I can hold out reprieve. There's another Thopter. I have to hold a reprieve here. Second Fable, oh, they just lose. Neat. Why did they know they lost? I guess they were just off it. because they didn't have Parthelion, Parhelion in their graveyard, or the other one. The sky, what's it? Sky Sovereign and Parhelion. It's a bad hand. I have to trust in the heart of the cards to draw the Foundry or the 2-drop Ingenious Smith. I should have played Mutavault there. It's a misplay. Counterspell. Should have attacked first as well. No counterspell. Mana Tithe. Ornithopter beats. Have Wandering Emperor, maybe? Settle the wreckage. I mean, I'll trade. Will I trade Ornithopter for planes? It's Wandering Emperor. I guess I could have played Pithing Needle. I guess I can play it now. They're just off it. If I put them on Wandering Emperor, I can name it preemptively. I mean, they just play it in response there. Oh, no, play it pre-combat, and then they can't use it. Well, they can. They still get a 2-2 out of it. I guess it, like, prompts them to do it. Show me the Foundry. That is not the Foundry. Another Yorian deck? got a pretty bad hand. Hey. Post-combat. Should have held the land until post-combat too. Foundry. Excellent. Now when I don't play it, they'll know what's going on. Guess I need to play it. I should have played Ornithopter first, so they can't remove the Foundry in response to me playing Ornithopter. That was a misplay. I could have had a 4-4 there. A sequencing error. And that was after I stalled on Mana Tithe, so it wasn't a rushing thing. It's just incorrect. I should have waited for them to pay before countering it. It's another misplay. Not countering it, but like remanding it. There we go. The Esper Sentinel Mana Tithe line is pretty great. I mean, now they just play a Wrath, and I go next. I guess that's what the Mutavaults are about. Four, five, seven. There's nothing for Lurus to interact with. They want two mana for some reason. Maybe it's one mana and the tax, but they just chose not to pay the tax, so. I don't think that's it. I think it's removal for Ingenious Smith. I mean, if I have him on that, then maybe I don't attack with Mutavault. Need to draw Roman. Yeah. There's Wrath. Which doesn't quite save them though, does it? This is my first time playing with Mutavault, and it's pretty amazing versus control. I guess that's obvious too. I'm trying to think of another man land that costs that little to activate. I guess they decided it was a more expensive ability. That one was undercosted. Smith, find me Foundry. Maybe. Perhaps Smith will find me Foundry. Are these slivers? Should have attacked first for best practices. I can have 1/2/2, or see these are gonna be these are both gonna get a charge next turn anyway. And there's another Ornithopter in my hand, so. Now. Oh, they're not. I don't have 3 mana. There we go. Thopter. A 4/4. The disaster. And it's a 4/4 that they want to die. Yikes. There's a counterspell, so I need to hold that up. Trading 5, 9, 13, 14. Five, nine, ten, put him at 5. So one Smith just bites the dust here. Five mana. Kiora untaps the land. I'm gonna go get more water. Double Mana Tithe. Maybe the Smith will find me the Foundry. Just tell them all about the Ornithopter. Why don't you? Arena. A traitor. I think I actually need to hold up Mana Tithe here. To tag Balmore. Ah. Oh. Should have played a Plains. That was a misplay. That's not Balmore. Well, that'll have to do. Cemetery Sages being 0-3 is kind of bizarre. There's two of them. Just play Ornithopter. Oh, because these are the unnerfed ones, right? Wait, no, they buffed it, they made it into a, I don't even know what's happening here. They added a toughness to it, I guess to try to create the wizard archetype. Did they already pay the one? Oh no, they let me draw the card. The wizard's archetype. They don't have another land. I guess I didn't have the luxury of not portable holing Cemetery Sage. Right on time. Kind of funny. Play the Ornithopter first this time. Three. Like they're playing around Mana Tithe anyway. Unless they just don't have a one mana card in their hand. That was supposed to target a Cemetery Sage, surely. It's a misplay. Now they remove Luris and I'm just doomed. They played the cards that they didn't want to get mana tithed. Good word, Arcanist goes back in their hand. Doesn't give it trample. So I need to draw planes here. It's not a planes, it's a counterspell. This is not enough, right? They flash it back and I lose. Oh wait, no, that's not true. I can make a Thopter to block. But I do have to do this now. So this is one, two, no, three, five, one activates, one makes the Thopter, and one casts Reprieve. Oh wait, ah, this is a misplay. No, it's not. Never mind. Okay. I guess they could find removal for the Thopter. Oh, wait, that's why I'm holding up Reprieve. Got you. White counterspells are a whole other trip. It's not a counterspell. White. Remanding. I'll be right back. I was on mute for that whole debacle. Show me Ornithopter. New Ornithopter. The opponent has something to play. Oh, I should have returned. Maybe I should have returned the Foundry to my hand. So they didn't have changed the equation anymore. That was the better play. That was a misplay. Instead of giving them back the counterspell. Hey. Four, eight, nine, 11, or just nine. And I play the Smith. I reveal this there. Maybe I'm supposed to play it in that situation. Because now they're not going to play into second Mana Tithe. Unless they think I'm bluffing. I guess that's an option. They're going to play the white and two, draw a card, gain life equal to cards in hand thing. Something third path. Union of the third path. Right here, union of the third path. This turned out to be more fun than it initially seemed. I had a bad run initially, and it is very weak to that Dimir mill deck. Very weak to it. Cartoonishly weak to it. I'll log off after this game. I'm still behaving as if it's 9:39 instead of 8:39. Is it actually barb spike here? I think it is. For the second potential 4/4. Otherwise, holding up Mana Tithe to what? Tap land anyway. Now I'll hold up Reprieve to try to win the game. Yeah. Good God. But yeah, that's gonna be it for me. And I shall return tomorrow. Take care.